Burns nothing.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down.
Solo left Zion.
Now Tua. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
So we've seen some good pressure defensively already here in the first quarter. Here's another good example.
Here's second and 10. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Tua now on first down. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Wilson.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's running well.
A good spot to throw, and indeed they'll come out with four wide receivers here on second and inches.
At the Jets, 38-yard line.
Looking to pass. Tua. This one complete to Jalen Waddle. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 24-yard line.
It's a gain of 14 yards. That's good for a Miami Dolphin. First and 10 at the 24-yard line.
Tua sets up to pass it. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Brings up second and 9 at the 23-yard line.
20, TX.
Going to the air. Tagovailoa. And incomplete on the deep ball.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. They'll look to throw here. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it breaks up 4th down.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on 3rd down. So far, only allowed 1 conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. And he's caught. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on 4th. Here's 1st and 10.
1st and 10 at the 11-yard line.
Back to throw again. Tyreek Hill's got another one. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. Tua wants to throw it on second down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Tua gonna throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
This defense is not gonna make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. They came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Mike McDaniel dialing up the risk here a little bit on fourth down. They're going to go for it. Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. Touchdown! Sam Wilson, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Dolphins' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And no, okay, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
Still first half, but they're going to line up for the onside kick. And the Jets have got it. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Well, this offense looks like they have a little extra pep in their step as they take the field here for drive number three, because remember, Charles, drives one and two both ended in the end zone.
Yeah, and right now they've just got to be careful not to lean into overconfidence, because every drive has a life of its own. But like the way that they've started, the way that they're going about doing things right now, they've got a chance for that third consecutive touchdown, and that would be a crushing blow to the defense.
So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Rodgers now on first down. And this is thrown to the sideline. No receiver in the area, though, and that's going to bring out a flag.
Yeah, he hadn't gotten far enough away from the pocket to throw that football away, and that draws the flag.
Yeah, the old tackle box, right? Get outside of each tackle, and then you can go ahead and throw it away, and you're in good shape. But if you're back there in the pocket, you got to make sure of what you're doing.
And Lazard's got it again. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 27 yards there, a first down. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers.
This is Lazard with a catch out left. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. So the completion good for 7 there. And that's going to bring up second down. Give to Cook out of the gun. And here he'll get it down to the 7. They're going to hurry back to the line now. To throw is Rodgers. His pass caught at the 4. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6. The Jets going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number 1. Two of their 3 red zone trips so far they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on 2nd and goal. He's got Wilson, and that's a Jets touchdown. A great play there as the first half is winding down. And the Jets will extend their lead here just before halftime. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And it's now 21-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Sauce Gardner picks it off. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Well, Charles, you were so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. This from 54 yards away. Zuerlein's kick is up and through, and that will do it for this first half. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down, 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. The Dolphins down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, still a good return. They'll start the drive right around the 37. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And you have to think, Charles, down 3 scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
The former 3rd overall pick, Quinnen Williams, there to bring him down.
Defenders are always happy anytime they can sack a quarterback for a loss of 10 or more yards. There's an example there. High fives all around.
Here's Tua. Under pressure, they got him again. The corner blitz gets there as he goes down for a loss of 7.
Now that's the way to start the second half. Back-to-back sacks. Whatever the halftime speech was, I hope they recorded it.
So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a 3rd and long. Looking to throw. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
Yeah, the punter Bailey on now as he sends this one away. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Jets will take over first and 10. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. On first down, Rodgers. Able to complete this one to Tyler Conklin. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Rodgers now on first down. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Celebration time because they finally forced an incompletion. He was perfect throwing the ball to that point.
Yeah, but from his viewpoint, they didn't force the incompletion. He just missed. That's how hot he is right now, and that's how he wants to continue to throw the ball.
Third quarter from Miami. This is second and 10. Throwing now is Rodgers. Got a man. That's Lazard. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 15-yard line. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. He's going to get this one down to Cook. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. And quickly, they get to the line. On second down, Cook. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Dalvin Cook, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jets are able to widen their advantage. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and the lead is now 24. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
At their own 29-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs. Because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
That's good for a Miami Dolphin.
From the gun, it's Tua. And the timing a bit off that time as Atwood falls to the ground.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have point.
He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Braxton Berrios, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Dolphins get a bit closer. And down near the goal line here, they're able to throw it in.
And the key word, quick. Quick hitter out of his hands fast, into the receiver's hands even faster.
Tua and the Dolphins offense staying put. They'll go for two. Tua going to try and throw for it.
It's caught at the one. So unable to throw it in for two from the two.
Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst, and if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
Go, 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 go. Now Rodgers going to shift him around. They'll try to meddle with Cook. Oh, and that one well designed as he'll take this down to the 30-yard line.
And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
Now they'll change things up.
They run again on first down, Cook. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Tackle at the 25-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup. Second and six.
They run it again with Cook. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down.
And it's third down.
Third down. Here's a run by Cook.
And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Three quarters in the books. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
52 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. This is a second and 4, ball at the 9.
Getting the ball is Cook running left. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It's a loss of 4. Now third down.
They have 3 tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
Touchdown, Jets. Tyler Conklin from 13 yards out as his guys have opened up a very comfortable lead. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it.
I know they're not asking me, but I'll give you my opinion anyway. I think it's time to erase that play from the call sheet. I guess they figure with the big lead, they can experiment a little bit. But all in all, just go ahead and put that play on ice.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick.
And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
At their own 28-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. But we said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD. But unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was insurmountable the way their opponent was playing. And, partner, they do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Now, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying.
Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Ashton Davis. And the Jets are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line.
Well, I get it, Charles. Desperate times call for desperate measures. Down big, they just sent their receivers out, let it fly. But the defense, they were ready.
Yeah, and there aren't too many people left in this stadium that couldn't see that coming. But that's not a major criticism at all, because you had to try it. What you're hoping for is one of your athletes out-athletes everyone else and makes a dramatic play.
Rodgers' throw here pulled in by Lazard.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And this one is incomplete.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 41-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. Rodgers to throw once more. He'll get this to Lazard. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. Zuerlein now for the PAT. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. It's caught inside the 10. But he gets in. And no one was expecting a fake there, but they add two more onto their lead. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Well, CD, it's all window dressing at this point. I mean, the best they can do is end the game with a nice drive to maybe build some momentum to move forward into their next contest.
Yeah, with how lopsided this game has been, even one score might not do a lot of cosmetic good on the scoreboard, partner, because it's just about looking forward at this point. Get a touchdown here, give yourself some positive momentum.
Over the middle, and there's a diving catch. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set.
That's another Dolphins first down. First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. The short throw there, that's to Smythe, the tight end. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
At the 42-yard line.
This is second and 8. Tua sets up to pass it. And he'll complete this one to Berrios. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 22-yard line. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Tua setting up shop to throw again. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Tua. And this is caught. Well, they get one back. Picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film. But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
Sanders now to add the extra point. And that will cut this lead down to 25. So it would no doubt be a miracle comeback from here, but let's see what they can do starting with the onside kick. And the Jets have got it. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we
see. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football, because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they just didn't get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and that'll cut the lead down to 18. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. First down, here's the run with Cook. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and that will extend their lead even further.
Well, ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the three, and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
We'll call it a convincing win here in this one, and we had some interesting plays throughout, maybe one of the most interesting, ending the game on an onside kick. They actually recovered it, but it didn't really matter.
No, you're exactly right, and maybe they just wanted to work on something, right? Even though it wouldn't have affected the final score, you work on it, you get it, you feel good about that. But I remember I had a coach who said, I don't waste those onside kicks. You don't get many of them anyway. Let's not use it when we don't need to.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. And with that, we sign off. Bit of he say, she say, getting no delay, run it like relay, bro, you ain't going like this. In my can't see straight, big fur jacket from eBay, looking timeless. I gotta let my skin fade, marinate. We gotta toast up, celebrate. Everyone screen next up, but I'm the number one candidate. Number one, captain's on, and I'm making key plays. When I'm doing shows, gotta get all prepaid. What you, I'm on it, break, no side, no about these ways. I gotta let my skin fade, marinate. We gotta toast up, celebrate. Everyone screen next up, but I'm the number one candidate. Number one. Star boy excellence. Them other guys irrelevant. They all on. Zoe Kravitz half white, half melanin. Baby face and a white gold tooth cap. I treat the waiter nice, she loved that. I mix the blueberry pie. It's not what I wear, it's how I rock that. If I can buy that twice, I'll cop that. Sweet one, 10-10, spot that, chop that. Tryna lock me, I can tell her it's not that. Do the he say, she say, getting no delay. Run it like relay, bro, you ain't going like this. In my can't see straight, big fur jacket from eBay, looking timeless. I gotta let my skin fade, marinate. We gotta toast up, celebrate. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to South Florida at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Today, a fun matchup in the AFC East, as it'll be the Buffalo Bills taking on the Miami Dolphins. Here's Jason Sanders now to get this one started, and we are underway from Miami. And from the end zone, Deontay Hardy will bring it out. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Allen looking to throw it right at the outset.
Throw right side, caught by Davis. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 11 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
That's a good start to the ball game. Maybe a little bit of a tone setter offensively. They come out throwing right away, and it's an early completion and a quick first down.
So the completion good for just three, and it's second down. To throw, it's Allen. That's caught by his tight end, Dawson Knox. Look at the big man rumble. Touchdown, Bills! Dawson Knox, 61 yards.
And the Bills march right down the field in three plays to claim the early advantage. Tyler Bass on for the extra point attempt.
And it's 7-0 Buffalo.
Makes the score Bills 7, Dolphins nothing. Tyler Bass to kick off for Buffalo.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up first and 10
at their 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And that's going to be incomplete.
Well, that was his first target of the game, and it's going to take at least one more target to get him on the board. Took a nice substantial hit to jar that catch loose from him. Incomplete pass.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25.
First carry for Raheem Mostert.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down.
The defense was dialed into the pass. They overlooked the draw play.
And how often do we talk about the oldies are still goodies? Because that draw play comes straight from Coach Paul Brown's playbook, going all the way back to the original Cleveland Browns.
On first down, Tagovailoa. He'll get this into the hands of Braxton Berrios. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that.
And they take him down. The Bills get to him.
Ed Oliver, that time, the one to get in there and bring him down. He found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
Well, they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it, did a great job of wrapping him up and bringing him down.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. A good chance this is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. He'll get it once more into the hands of Hill. He's going to be a yard short. Needed two, but only got one. Fourth down.
Interesting decision here. Opening drive, Charles, fourth and short. You're in field goal range. We'll see what they do.
I just shake a fist at my offense and say, go get it, guys, because if you can't pick up fourth and short here, we're probably in trouble the rest of the game. Show some confidence, show some aggressiveness. Go pick it up.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. Well, I guess they wanted to get that touchdown right back on their first drive, but failed to do so.
And what they have to be careful of is pushing so hard to stay right there, to stay even with their opponent, that it gassed themselves out. You know, it's almost like horse racing. Sometimes you don't want to take your horse right to the front and let them do all the work and then someone catch them at the end and pass them up. You want to make sure you moderate what you're doing along the way and then go for the big finish.
Now Allen. And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
Throwing is Allen on third. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Throwing on first down is Allen. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs, 44 yards. And the Bills lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game.
They've got to be thrilled on the road right now. Touchdown, turnover, touchdown, and quickly trying to make it 14-0.
Yeah, and mentioned it already. On the road, to be able to go into someone else's house and establish a start like that.
Here's Bass now to send it away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They've got some stuff to build on from that last drive because they moved the football, CD, and then they tried to go for it on fourth down, didn't convert, probably left a bitter taste in their mouths.
I would say so, and I think that they go out in this series determined for that not to happen again. In fact, they don't even want to get to a fourth down opportunity. They just want to make sure they get it done within the parameters that they've set for themselves. Run their offense, get it into the end zone. Yeah, I think a little bit of determination and a dash of anger.
Tua now on first down. Oh, looking for Waddle, but it's intercepted. Pick made by Terrell Bernard. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an intercept.
Touchdown! Stephon Diggs. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Bills are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Asidi, that's his second touchdown already. And how about this offense? Three drives, three touchdowns.
An absolute total team effort right now. And let's face it, I don't think he's done. We're still in the first half. There's a lot of time left to go. I don't know what they're going to do on the other side trying to slow him down. But right now, he's feeling it.
And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive.
And this, you'd hate to say that a drive in the first half must end in points, but you're down 21-0. They're going to have to get something going fairly quickly.
I would agree totally with that, because if you're going to mount the comeback, it's going to have to come in bits and pieces. It doesn't just all come at one time, right? We haven't seen anything more than a six-point touchdown ever in this game, right? So that's how it has to be done. Get points on the board now. Start your comeback. But you're exactly right. Let's get it going right here in this spot.
Setting the throw on first down is Tua. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's second down now. Brings up second and 10. Tua to throw again. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. That's Gregory Rousseau getting in there to bring him down. So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. He's got his target. That's complete. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Out to the right here to Wilson.
give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 5 at the Bills' 17-yard line.
Looking to pass, Tua. Out route to Hill, complete. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Here's Tua. That's complete to Mostert out of the backfield. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3.
Brings up second and goal.
Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. Touchdown, Dolphins! Tua fighting his old Alabama teammate, Jalen Waddle. And the Dolphins are able to cut into that deficit. Well, that connection, it looked like they maybe had some pre-play communication. Maybe one of them noticed an area that was open to the defense to get the pass to.
When you put the time in, sometimes you have that great silent communication that you just noticed right there, because the best quarterback-receiver combos in the NFL, they know how to make those adjustments at the line of scrimmage when they see something pre-play, and they got it done there.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. A lot of time for this unit to game plan on the sideline after that drive that they watched the other side just score. But remember, last time they were out, they scored as well. We'll see if they can seize that momentum right back.
And they have had a lot of time to cool off from reaching the end zone the last time. So have they been able to keep themselves mentally sharp and into this game, even though they haven't been on the field? And you and I both know, one big play, though, gets them right back up to that level.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Allen looks to throw on second down. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
Allen from the gun on third down. Oh, a first mistake for him in the ball game as it's intercepted. Picked off by Deshaun Elliott. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Ready.
After the turnover, it's Tua. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. From the gun, it's Tua. Caught by Wilson. They'll give him 4 yards there, and it'll be second down. The Dolphins moving with a sense of urgency here. Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they're going to have a first down and also right in the field goal range, all the way down to the 15 here. And again, it's Tagovailoa. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Durham Smythe, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Dolphins get a late score here. First half.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did. They didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. So they fake the handoff. Now Allen. That's into a crowd and intercepted. There he goes, right side.
Whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's that made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The whole club.
White to be shooting in the eyes. I'm sleeping good at night. See the door don't got no locks. So despite bullshit best friends with the ops. And that you need better stocks. Standing on my money, dog. Please don't get the involved. Ain't nobody running off. Rules to the basics. I can't be no son-in-law. I can't take the summer off. I make it look good and all, but this is no vacation. All the goons, they respect me and I know it. Watch your words and your tone, you're not a pug. My advice, please don't try to be heroic. Let me know that
whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. I met her at a club. She twerk better when her heart breaks. Hey, hey, hood, the one I wanna. Everything that I can
for a Bentley and to never go to jail. I'm fresh up out the gutter, I don't know if you can tell. A hustler for everything I do for legacy. You can call me any type of day, my dog, I never sleep. The only rule I got is if we don't embarrass me. I write down my problems, then record it just for therapy. Just for clarity, old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. Yeah, old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The whole club.
Talk is cheap.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweet.
Get that boy out of there.
It's a sweet.
Get that boy out of there.
We ain't playing no games. We playing for keeps.
Yeah.
It's a sweet. It's my time, not no Patty Philippe. They was yapping, I don't hear a peep.
What?
Yeah, I step through that spot, I don't creep.
Yeah, we ain't on none of that.
Can't call it lucky, I give it my all every day of the week.
You know what I'm on.
I see a crowd at the bottom, ain't with that, I climb to the peak.
Boy, straight to the top.
Don't ride no red, but they know what I'm on. They address me as chief. I be dripping water like a reef. Slid off with the bag, but I ain't no thief. It's a sweet, they ain't even have a chance. I been locked on that cash in a trance. Hit the end zone and do my little dance. Yeah, your chick blowing kisses like Lance. Should go tell your mans. It's a sweet.
What?
It's a sweet.
Yeah.
What? Acting like we ain't the ones, man. Talk is cheap.
set to do battle here, as it'll be the Pittsburgh Steelers taking on the Chicago Bears. Here's the punter, Trenton Gill, now to do the honors, and off we go here at Soldier Field. And they will elect to not bring this one out, as our first drive will begin at the 25. Throwing first play is Pickett. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Harris. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and six at the 29-yard line.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Back to throw, Pickett. It's complete to Robinson. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Getting it to him in space pays off big time. That winds up going for 31.
Well, things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone, this time with a big pass play.
And if the peek behind the curtain that they gave us or their game plan today, I don't think that's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that.
And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
And from the 34, here's second and four. Looking to throw, Pickett. That swung out wide to Harris. And he'll go down at the 28. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Pickett to throw on first down. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two.
But
yet another completion here on this opening drive, and he's now perfect 4 of 4 to start. Pretty solid execution here.
And how about how everyone's handled their nerves? Because you know what it's like to start a ball game. You're so amped up and ready to go, but sometimes the execution isn't there. They've been flawless so far. Well drilled, well prepared, and excited to start this game.
Mark, that is a gain of 16 to set him up first and goal.
Well, no question, this is exactly how they wanted to start this football game. And nice pass there. Now they're set up beautifully, Charles, to finish this off with a touchdown.
Yeah, but they've still got to finish it off, partner, and that means they've got to execute at this stage of the field. So we've seen many teams march it right to the goal line and not cash in. They've got something dialed up here that puts it in the end zone.
And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. Pickett back to throw. That throw finds Pickens in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. A 3-yard touchdown pass. And the Steelers put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. Well, down here, I thought they were going to hand that off. Instead, a well-designed play and the pitch and catch for the touchdown.
And I wonder who came up with it. Was it a call from the bench? Did the quarterback have a good idea and suggest it? In any event, clearly an effective play call. They saw something they liked in coverage, and they targeted it for the short yardage throw.
And the perfect way to cap their opening drive. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Scott on the return out of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10 at their own 22. Fields now to throw. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And they work this well upfield across the 45. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to probably get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Now it's Fields. And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. On second down, here's Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 31-yard line. To throw is Fields. Forced out to his left. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Here's Fields. Right side, Claypool's got it. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. A shotgun snap, Fields. Open man, he finds Kmet. Touchdown, Chicago. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Bears are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Santos able to tack on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And it'll come out to the 25. Austin not going to try and return it. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Now a first down carry for Harris. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Ball spotted at the 45. Here's a second down at 6. Here's Pickett. Shakes, but now he's swallowed up and taken down. They push him back 8 yards that time on second down.
Got to give him points for the attempt, but there's just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
Pickett and the Steelers in need of a big play here. Third and long after the sack.
They'll set up a throw. And that will be incomplete.
And that's a good bounce back up to give them a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down per minute and then out. Obviously, no loss of confidence with that defense. And now they get to turn it back to their offense.
Looks like the offense is going to take another shot here. They're going on 4th and 13. Going for it on 4th down. Here's Pickett. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And the Bears are going to have a short field here as they'll take over right at the 50.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively, getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. Larry Ogunjobi in for the sack.
They tried to go with a little play action there, but nobody on the defensive side bit.
Yeah, they adjusted in time and in a big way and ultimately got the sack on offense. Sometimes you're running play action just to set up a certain blocking technique. In this case, none of it worked.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up, it's 7.
Here we go.
A tough spot here, 3rd and 15. Here's Fields. Over the middle, complete. That's Moore. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
And I believe that that gain on 3rd and long changes things quite a bit, because this would be a very long field goal. I wouldn't be surprised to see him go for it here.
Here we go on 4th down, Fields. He's got his running back out of the backfield. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Well, they deemed it 4-down territory, and they got 4 yards to pick up the first.
Here we go, Scott.
Now Fields. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. Now he's loose down the left sideline. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's 1st and 10. Back to throw, Fields. Oh, he had a man open. He overshot him. It's incomplete.
Looked like they were set up defensively in a zone coverage, but somehow they found a seam, because that receiver, all alone, by rights, that should have been a touchdown, but somehow this ball's overthrown.
Touchdown, Bears! Justin Fields fighting Darnell Mooney, and the Bears have taken the lead. Well executed there offensively. Defense looked a little confused, but he found his receiver, and that went good for 6 points.
And the payoff we just saw there tells us how many times they ran this play in practice over the past few weeks, because they executed that flawlessly right here on game day when the situation arose.
Santos with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, here's the punter, Trenton Gill, to kick it away. And it'll come out to the 25. Austin not going to try and return it. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive. And they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp. and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half.
Pickett and the Steelers in need of a big play here. Third and long after the sack.
They'll drop to throw.
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
Locates Claypool on the crossing route.
Touchdown! Chase Claypool as the first half is winding down.
And the Bears would extend their lead here just before halftime.
Santos able to tack on the extra point, and it's now 21-7.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust them.
But it's intercepted. They got Pickett for the third time in this game. Picked up by Jalen Jackson.
And a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half.
Now a first down throw, Fields.
And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
That's tremendous field position that they were given following the turnover, but they've still got work to do to get to field goal range, and the coverage we're seeing isn't going to make it easy.
On second and 10, Fields.
Escaping the pressure right.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone.
And oh, it'll be intercepted.
Picked off by Joey Porter Jr. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half.
So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. And the Bears hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. A very interesting call of one of the backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know, the special teams coordinators. They sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
T.J. Watt in on the tackle.
From the 25, here's second and nine.
Brings up second and nine.
On second down, a run with Herbert.
Takes this one in for a Bears touchdown.
Khalil Herbert,
25 yards to the house.
And the Bears are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Now the point after try for Santos.
And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. After the touchdown, here's the punter Trenton Gill to kick it away. And it'll come out to the 25. Austin not going to try and return it. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them in the turnovers, they've had issues keeping the football in their possession.
In every game that's ever been played, all coaches talk about taking care of the football and limiting turnovers. And in this one, after we saw that first turnover, we worried that things would snowball, and it certainly did, especially on the scoreboard.
And they're going to speed things up here. First and 10, here's Pickett. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And they will score a pick six for the Bears touchdown.
And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. As confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away.
And it'll come out to the 25. Austin not going to try and return it.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here.
And oh my goodness, here's a fifth interception. Tyreek Stevenson picks it off.
Well, there's two sides to this coin. I mean, on one side, 5 interceptions now thrown for him. That's tough, but man, this defense, they have been ball hawking and impressive. But Charles, let's flip it back over. If you're coaching a quarterback that's struggling this much at this stage of the game, do you maybe try to get him out?
I would think about it, and I think about it awfully hard, but also you might want to look into his eyes, see what he has. He might be one of those players that you don't want to affect his confidence by actually pulling him out of the game. So you have to know your player, you have to know the situation.
Fields. And his throw is incomplete. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing 4-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on 3rd and 15. Fields on first down. He's going to air one out. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
They certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
Again, Fields. Themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 13-yard line. The play goes for 19 yards, gives them a new set of downs.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Now here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground, and now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
Second and 10, Fields again. And he's got Mooney in the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Darnell Mooney, his second touchdown of the night. And the Bears get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. Boy, he has been fun to watch throwing the football in this one. It's certainly not fun for that defense, though, Charles. Now up to four touchdown passes in this ball game.
Yeah, we're supposed to be neutral, but I'm feeling their pain right now because he has absolutely carved up this secondary. A clinic on how to attack the defense and take them out of the game.
Well, after the touchdown, here's the punter, Trenton Gill, to kick it away. And it'll come out to the 25. Austin not going to try and return it. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 43. Working out of the gun, it's Pickett. That's down the field and caught by Freiermuth. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Pat Freiermuth, 43 yards. And the Steelers are able to at least get one score back.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets ahead of steam going. And as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
Well, Pickett and the rest of the Steeler offense staying on the field. They'll go for two. They'll look to throw. And he will get into the end zone to shave two more points off the deficit. He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
Yes, the Steelers have it. Well, I guess they felt like they needed something to get them going. Maybe you wait for this type of a play, but they try the onside kick, and it works.
I'm starting to wonder if the analytics coach is starting to get involved in the football nowadays. When you see this type of play made, this type of a risk taken, sometimes there's a different influence that's going into the head coach's ear.
That's complete to Robinson. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
There's a nice pickup right there. And after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Pickett, he'll look to throw it. Finding Johnson on the out route, that's complete. So just 3 yards on the completion there, and it's second down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Now Pickett, he's got this to his running back, Harris. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. 17 yards on the catch and run, it's a first down. And with this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
Well, we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline because he certainly wants him to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
A gain of 8 there on the play, and it'll be second in a couple. Pickett right back to the air again. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Third and two, Pickett. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Jaquan Brisker, and the Bears are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27. And I think we can get used to seeing more of that in this fourth quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bully. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning. Trying to ice a game, plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner and pound away and try and finish off the game.
Nice pickup, 10 yards and a first down on the keeper.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Herbert. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And the tackle there by Quan Alexander.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Now a second and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete. The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do.
And that's caught inside the 30. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. So still throwing here in the fourth quarter with a pretty sizable lead, and now that lead even more sizable. And if nothing else here, CD, a chance to pile on some stats before this one wraps up, and he did just that.
Brandon Convention tells us it's time for them to get off the gas a little bit, right? But you and I both know the receivers don't want them to, because, as you noted, this is their chance to pile on the stats. If they got their way, they try to get every single spot in the depth chart points before this game is over.
And it'll come out to the 25. Austin not going to try and return it. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game. The self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made.
And my goodness, another interception. Tyreek Stevenson picks it off, and they will score a pick six for the Bears touchdown. Santos now to end the PAT. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This fielded right at the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest,
don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today, coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
First down, Pittsburgh.
Pickett now on first down.
And now here is another interception. Eddie Jackson picks it. Down the sideline he goes. And they will score. Pick six for Bears touchdown.
That impressive performance just became a little bit more impressive here as they add yet another score to the ledger late in the fourth quarter.
And not much has stopped them at any point in this game, partner. This is just an old-fashioned blowout right here. They probably could put the brakes on themselves, but they elected not to and played this one all the way out.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And a mistake on the lateral. It's a loose ball. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secure. And a lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
Pickett's throw here taken in by Boykin. And he's taken down. It's a gain of three from the 17 to the 20. Second and seven from the 20. Here's Pickett. And this will be caught by his big wide receiver. The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Pickett will look to throw it here. Over the middle, it's complete. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Second and five. Pickett now from the gun here. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Jalen Johnson. And the Bears are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They came into this one with a vision, Charles, and it has played out exactly as they had hoped, if not even better. They've got the huge lead here, and now the football for the final moments of the fourth.
Yeah, and it was apparent that they were the better team, right? We figured that out pretty early. But give them a lot of credit for staying with it. They didn't stumble around out there. They didn't create a lot of errors for themselves because they were the superior team. They took care of business and closed them out pretty quickly.
Well, fans usually love to see scoring, and there was no shortage of it today. What a dominant showing from an offense that was truly playing at an elite level in this contest.
Partner, this game was over a long time ago, and you noticed they did not want to slow down anything. Absolutely a dream scenario for everyone on that offense, and they took advantage of every second. Guaranteed popcorn for everyone in their film session.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden. Texas up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down.
Brings up second and five.
Lawrence will throw. That's going to be caught by Kirk. And Kirk is going to have the Jaguars first down as he'll get this out past the 35-yard line. Lawrence finding Kirk there for the Jaguar first.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
Now Lawrence to throw. And one more time, here's Kirk. And that's good for a gain of 6, and that'll bring up second down. And he's already got 2 catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball, and sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
And ETN going to have a Jags first down as a tackle made up at the 48-yard line. 2 first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Throwing again here, it's Lawrence. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. Touchdown, Jaguars! Evan Ingram, 52 yards! And the Jaguars get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Charles, that was a heck of a play.
It truly was, because when he made that catch, he had to shake through some people, right? So that play, to me, a highlight film that should be accompanied by bass music, right? I mean, boom, 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 and he finds his way to the end zone. Terrific play.
Well, look at this. They got the 7-0 lead in the pocket, and they're going to try an onside kick. And this is going to be taken in by the Colts. So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely. Magic there.
It's not apparent, is it? You almost have to go deeper, I think, and maybe if we try and work along with them and speculate a little bit here, they must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game. And maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They've got to steal it and try and gain an advantage. And they tried. Okay, they just didn't get it done.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. Powers through. They'll get it across the 35. It'll be second down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
And we're going to see this offense try and spread the field a little bit and utilize the outside third of the field, especially against man coverage. But that time, the defense was up to the task, forcing the incompletion.
On third down, here's Richardson. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. Touchdown, Colts! Kylan Granson. 64 yards. And the Colts are an extra point away from evening this one up. Those are the drives that prove a lot. You got a rookie quarterback, Charles. You're on the road, takes him down, throws the touchdown pass.
And in a game like this, with, as you described, a rookie quarterback, the team usually says, okay, we got to take care of this guy. We got to protect him. But when he goes out and plays like this on the first drive on the road, he doesn't have to say, I'm here to be your leader. They just need to follow him.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They'll start on the ground, ETN, and not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
On second down, here's Lawrence. He'll drop this one off with ETN. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And now third down and six to go.
And that's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, short tackle.
Short completion, just 4 yards. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game. But it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go and make the tackle right away.
And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
I remember pregame when we were talking to him on the field, and he took his gloves off and showed us his fingers. A few misshapen ones in there, and now we know why, trying to catch those types of bullets.
That was a dart. Yeah, even for a talented receiver, those are tough to hang on to. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
You've always been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stop. These two teams all tied after one. Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Again, it's Lawrence. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A pickup of 27. And they pick up the first down in the process. Looking to throw, Lawrence. He targets Ingram for another grab. Touchdown, Jaguars! Evan Ingram with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Jaguars have taken the lead.
So they get their tight end away from the line to the outside, and he works his way in for six.
Tight ends are not just blockers anymore. I don't know how many more times we need examples, but here's a great one. Gets to the outside, they give him the ball pretty quickly, and they trust him to get those extra yards, and boy, did he come through, bowling his way into the end zone after the nice catch.
Now McManus to tack on the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And Dallas Flowers going to bring this out of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. And he just danced away from that one defender on his way to a gain of about 7 yards.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They go play action with Richardson. He'll buy some time right. And he'll just get rid of it.
I tell you what, that's a veteran play from a guy in his first season in the NFL. A lot of rookies are trying to force something there. He thought better of it, and that was the right decision.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Richardson on third and short. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line.
And Richardson back to throw it. And that one to the right side and incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Richardson on second and 10. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
The touch and timing are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions.
Richardson.
Flushed out right. And he'll go out of bounds after taking a little further down inside the 40. Decent gain on the scramble to six, but now it's fourth.
Thanks to his effort, they now have a big choice to make here. He just ran them into field goal range with that one, so here come the choices. Do they kick it here, or do they trust him to make another big play and possibly get a first down?
Too long for a field goal, too short to punt that in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. Going for it on fourth, here's Richardson. Buying time to his left. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Colts unable to convert here on fourth down. And the Jaguars are going to take possession here on the turnover on downs. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
From the bottom, blood on my hands, ain't no dirt on my body, whip big body.